Growing up in Southern California, I was always around extreme sports. Motocross was just kind of like a religion for me. I lived and breathed racing, and I was racing at a national at Freestone County Raceway on November 18, 2006. And I went over the finish line jump and I got landed on by another rider. I was knocked out for a few minutes and I woke up and realized that I couldn't move my right arm, which was my dominant arm at the time. And I ended up getting paralyzed with a brachial plexus injury. And then about a few months after, me and my dad got hit by a drunk driver and we flipped 4 times in our truck. And everything I was starting to gain back, like my bicep muscle and a few nerve endings, I instantly lost.
A devastating series of events left Kiana Clay with a paralyzed right arm. However, she was determined to follow her passion for racing and competitive sport, and she's now doing that in the world of adaptive snowboarding.
I fell in love with snowboarding when I first started, when I was 4 years old. I've been surfing and skateboarding and everything my entire life, and I really loved the feel of snowboarding. Being able to carve on a mountain and embrace the different type of elements that were around me, because I'm like, I can enjoy dirt with my dirt bike, water with my surfboard, concrete with my skateboard, and now snow with a snowboard. So whenever you're a little adrenaline junkie that just wants to go fast, I definitely fell in love with it instantly whenever I went down the mountain. Kind of like every day when I go onto the mountain, I always have at least one lifty that looks at me and they're like, oh, that's so sick. Like, nothing's stopping you, like you're riding with one arm. And I explain to them, like, yeah, it's paralyzed. And like, oh, you're paralyzed. Okay, that's a little different. That's still super sick that you're out here. Like, that's incredible. Because I'd probably be at home, like, just chilling on the couch and not snowboarding. Like, I wouldn't want to risk getting hurt. And I always tell people the same thing, you know, I'd rather go out and live my life than sit and think about all the things that I can't do. So I'm gonna figure out a way to do what I love, and that's definitely every adaptive athlete's mentality. So with snowboarding, when I decided to start riding again 2 seasons ago, I figured out that trying to get my balance is incredibly difficult because I don't have my back arm to kind of keep me stable on the board. And so trying to stay stacked in the position that I'm supposed to be in, the athletic position, is really difficult because I don't know if I'm having too much weight forward or too much weight back. I usually figure out once I cross edge and I fall and I'm like, okay, I was doing this wrong. But during the time, it's really hard for me to figure out where my balance is. And then especially on jumps, whenever I'm jumping, if I lose my balance and I roll down the windows, it actually messes me up more. So there are pros and cons, but balance is definitely a struggle for sure.
Hoping to make Kiara's life on the slopes a little easier, snowboard company Burton have teamed up with engineer Chris Doyle to create a groundbreaking invention in the world of adaptive snowboarding, the step-on binding. This allows athletes to simply step onto the board without the difficulty of attaching traditional straps.
Burton has become involved with adaptive athletes ever since I started there 23 years ago, when the 800 number would ring with an athlete or a rider that maybe had a different ability or a disability, and they always ended up coming to me to help them out. When we started developing step-on, that became very clear to me right away that step-on was going to be a real game changer for athletes of different ability levels. And so I started focusing on that. And as I started to focus on that, I became more aware of the prosthetics that athletes were using. And I started to contact the makers of those prosthetics, tell them what my intents and interests were, and working with them more directly. The idea is to try to make snowboarding more fun, easier, and inclusive for all riders that want to ride.
One of those riders is gold medal winning Paralympian Mike Schultz. The American, who lost his leg in a snowmobile accident, has been involved in the process of making the perfect step-on binding for adaptive snowboarding athletes.
Lined up with Burton about 2 years ago. He reached out to me through some other snowboarders that I'm great friends with. Yeah, Doyle reached out to me and said that he was really intrigued and interested in helping out the adaptive snowboarding world, and said he had this great new binding coming out, the step-on binding, and explained what it was all about. And I'm like, heck yeah, this sounds pretty awesome. Not having to worry about straps, just stomping into them. And so then that kind of got the ball rolling with a project with the University of Vermont students about what could we do to further specialize adaptive equipment for snowboarding, just to make it even that much better and more accessible. And so we've got some cool things in the works.
Everything that these riders do is hard. Everything. And so what we're trying to do is identify the things that are the most difficult. Using straps, putting your boots on, closing your boots, and making all of that easier. Other things that we're working on are coats are really hard to do with one hand. Getting your helmet done, goggles. So there's so many different ways that we could help out that we maybe not have thought about so much in the past, but now it's really fantastic to think about these things and focus on them for this whole group of riders that I personally believe are underserved.
It's funny because like whenever I'm training with my team and I have to buckle in my bindings, I'm always having to reach over with one hand, and they're both doing it, like all my teammates do it with both hands, and they do it real fast, and they usually have to wait for me. And so the first day they got the step-on bindings, we got to the top of the lift, and I just stepped in and clipped on. I looked at them, I was like, damn guys, you guys are slow. Like, what's taking so long?
I really enjoy seeing the excitement that everybody has that's working on the project. And you know, the best part is like this, we get to go out and test it and go ride, and eventually, hopefully, we come up with a really good system that helps a lot of people out tread even that much harder.
If there's like a roadblock in your way, get creative and find a way around that roadblock. Like for me, one of my roadblocks was, how am I gonna put my hair up with a ponytail? Because I work out a lot. So I had to get creative, and I figured out how to do that with a doorknob. And Xbox, I play it with my feet. You know, have that be a fire for you, and just kind of look at that in every aspect, even if it's not sports. So just really getting creative and not letting any barriers get in the way.